क्लास 10। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 16 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 5.2। द क्वेश्चन इज डिटरमाइन द एपी हुज थर्ड टर्म इज 16 एंड सेवेंथ टर्म एक्सीड्स द फिफ्थ टर्म बाय 12। सो इन दिस द थर्ड टर्म इज गिवन टू यू 16, दैट मीन्स A3 इज इक्वल टू 16 एंड द सेवेंथ टर्म एक्सीड्स द फिफ्थ टर्म बाय 12, दैट मीन्स सेवेंथ टर्म इज ग्रेटर देन फिफ्थ टर्म बाय 12। सो A7 माइनस A5 विल बी इक्वल टू 12। So let us just start solving the question. Question number 16. In the question, A3 is given to us. It is equals to 16, and A7 minus A5 is equals to 12. So how can we write A3? A plus n minus 1. That means 3 minus 1 into d is equals to 16. And here A7 is A plus 7 minus 1 d minus A plus 5 minus 1 D is equals to 12. This will be A plus 3 minus 1 is 2 D is equals to 16. This will be our equation number 1. Now this A plus 6 D minus A plus 4 D is equals to 12. Multiply this minus to both the terms, you will get A plus 6D minus A minus 4D is equals to 12. A got cancelled and 6D minus 4D is 2D is equals to 12. From here we got D is equals to 12 upon 2. Cancel this, that's 6. So from this we got the value of D as 6. Now put value of D in equation 1. So A plus 2 into 6 is equals to 16. So A plus 12 is equals to 16. That means A will be equals to 16 minus 12, which is equals to 4. So now we will form the AP. So the first term is 4. Next term will be A plus D. A plus D means 4 plus 6, 10. The next will be A plus 2D. That means 2D is 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. 16 plus 4, 20. 20 plus 4, 24 and so on. Now next question, question number 17. Find the 20th term from the last of the AP. 3, 8, 13 and 253. So AP is given to us. We have to find the 20th term from the last. That means from 253. So we'll take this as our first term A. Start solving. So AP which is given to us is 3, 8, 13 and so on up to 253. Now we have to find the 20th term from this, from here. This will be our first term for that. So we'll take A as 253, N is your 20, now D. Now see, when we take this A as the first term, then D is A2 minus A1. Now we are taking this as A. So now we have to, this will take A2 and this will is A1. So 3 minus 8 will be your minus 5. Now solve for A20 is equals to A plus 20 minus 1 into D. A is your 253 plus 19 into minus 5. So it's 253 minus 95. Now subtract it, you'll get the 20th term from the last is 8. 5 and here 1. So 20th term from last term is 158. Okay, now next question, the question number 18. Next question, question number 18 is the sum of 4th and 8th term of AP is 24. And the sum of 6th and 10th term is 44. Find the first three terms of the AP. So in this, the fourth term and eighth term sum is given to us 24. The sum of sixth and tenth term is 44. So for this, we will take A4 plus A8 is equals to 24 and A6 plus A10 is equals to 44. From this, we will form two equations. Then we will solve those two equations to find our AP. So start solving here. Question number 18. A4 plus A8 is equals to 24 and A6 plus A10 is equals to 44. Now, what can we write for A4? A4 is equals to A plus 4 minus 1 into D, that is A plus 3D. Okay, and A8 will be equals to A plus 8 minus 1 into D, that means it is A plus 7D. A6 will be A plus 6 minus 1 into D, A plus 5D. And A10 is equals to A plus 10 minus 1 into D is equals to A plus 9D. Now use these values in these two. So this A plus 3D plus A plus 7D is equals to 24. This will become 2A plus 10D is equals to 24. Mark this as equation number 1. Now next one is A plus 5D plus A plus 9D is equals to 44. This will be 2A plus 14D is equals to 44. Equation number 2. Now here we can see that A has the same coefficient. So now the coefficient of A is same, of same sign. So we'll subtract equation 1 from equation 2. So this will be 2A plus 14D is equals to 44 and 2A plus 10D is equals to 24. Change the signs first. Negative, negative, positive, negative. Cancelled. 4D is equals to 20. So D will be equals to 20 upon 4. We got D as 5. Now put value of D in equation 1. 2A plus 10 into 5 is equals to 24. So 2A is equals to 24 minus 50. From here we will get that 2A is equals to minus 26. So A is equals to minus 13. Now form the AP. First term is minus 13. Minus 13 plus 5 is minus 8. Minus 8 plus 5 is minus 3 and so on. So we have to find the first three terms of the AP. The first three terms of AP are minus 13, minus 8 and minus 3. Now we'll do the next question, that is question number 19. What is question number 19? Subba Rao started work in 1995 at an annual salary of rupees 5000 and received an increment of rupees 200 each year. In which year did his income reach rupees 7000? So in this, it is given to us, we'll take this as first year. And this will be a common difference because every year the increment is rupees 200. So increment is given to us. First term is given to us 500 and the term which we have to find, number of term, is given to us, that is 700. We will solve this with the AP. So how to solve? Here we will take that A is your 5000. D is 200. And AN is your 7000. We have to find N. Which year? So AN is equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. In place of AN, 7000 is equals to 5000 plus N minus 1 into D is 200. Shift this 5000 to this side. You will get 7000 minus 5000 is equals to n minus 1 into 200. 200. When we solve this, you will get 2000 upon 200, because 200 here it is in multiplication, and minus 1. So cancel them. This is 10. So n will be equals to 10 plus 1. So n is your 11. N is 11. So in which year his income reached 7000? In 11th year, his income will reach 7000. Okay. Now going to the next question, question number 20. 20th question. Ramkali saved rupees 5 in the first week of a year, then increased her weekly saving by rupees 1.75. So here the common difference here is 1.75, and your A will be rupees 5. We have to find N weeks, that means the Nth term. When Nth term is given to us, we have to find the term. Which term is this? Okay. So again we will solve this with an AP. In question number 20, A we will take as 5 rupee, D is your 1.75, AN is 20.75, and N we have to find. So again using this, AN is equals to A plus N minus 1 into D. In place of AN, 20.75 is equals to 5 plus N minus 1 into D is 1.75. Bring 5 here, 20.75 minus 5 is equals to n minus 1 into 1.75. Solve this. 75 is equals to n minus 1 into 1.75. So this 1.75 is in multiplication, this side will come in division. This is 1.75. We have to divide this. Decimal, decimal gone. Divide this with 5. This will be 35, and here it is 3, 1, and 5. Again with 5, this will be 7, and this will be 63. This will go with 7, 9. So n is equals to 9 plus 1. So n is equals to, the value of n is 10. So in which week the saving will be 20.75? In 10th week the saving become rupees 20.75. So we have completed our exercise 5.2. The next exercise, that is 5.3, will start in our next video.